Each day stronger, one day longer, each day stronger.
One day longer, each day stronger. One day longer, each day stronger.
The board of our revolution met yesterday, and we issued a statement loud and clear that we will stand when any one of us is attacked. All of us will stand and fight back. They won't come for us one at a time. Every time, it'll be all of us. At Standing Rock, it's all of us. If they come for Union brothers and sisters, which they will in this next government, it's all of us. When they come to destroy our climate, we will all stand back. Stand up and fight back. When they come for immigrants, our sisters and brothers, to deport them, we'll stand with every one of them and fight back. We'll stand with every one of them and fight back. And when there are hate crimes around us, we will stand with every sister and brother attacked, and we will fight back. And at the same time that we stand up and fight back, we'll remember what we learned in the last year, that we could unite 13 million of us to fight for real change and vote for real change, and that we won't give up that fight. That political revolution goes on. That is our revolution, wherever we come from, whatever we are like. We are united by a movement. We're united by our values. We're united by a sense that this global economy needs to work for all of us. And we're inspired that we stood up against the Trans-Pacific Partnership and we beat it back. We beat it back. We beat it back. We beat it back. Because for 5 years we fought it and we were here one day longer, even than this president, who many of us loved. And we were here longer than the Chamber of Commerce and the Business Roundtable. And all the bastards that bring us these trade deals and bring us a global economy that's for them. It's never enough for them. Well, you know what? It's our time. Standing Rock is sounding the alarm loud and clear. Whether it's this president or the next one, we're all gonna be there, standing up and fighting back. And how long? One day longer, each day stronger. One day longer, each day stronger. One day longer, each day stronger.
Please inundate Obama's mailbox. Please divest from your banks. These are the necessary actions we have to take, because this is not gonna get done if we don't stand up and do it. So thank you for being here, and thank you for taking this powerful message that Standing Rock has shown us, that you can peacefully protest, that you can stand up with ceremony and with prayer as your weapons. We can all do that in our Western world. Because when we say we're standing with Standing Rock, we're also standing with the Native Hawaiians who are protesting against the telescopes that are being built on their mountains, their sacred mountains on Mauna Kea on the Big Island. We are standing with every indigenous culture around this world. And we are standing with not only their future generations, but with our future generations. It is time to unite the nations. It is time to change these awful narratives that we have been fed as Westerners that are not true. You have the opportunity to educate yourself not only about the Dakota Access Pipeline right now, but about Native Americans, because the narrative that we know is not the right narrative. So take the time today to ask questions, to find who's Native in this crowd, and see how you can't do anything to change Standing Rock, but how you can support what they're doing. And if you haven't been to Standing Rock already, I encourage you to go. But I do want you to know that you have to go in a good way. And you have to go to speak to understand, not to speak to be heard. When you go to Standing Rock, whatever your intention or whatever you think you may do there, you're gonna leave and realize that you didn't do anything, but it did something to you. Because it is a spiritual change that we are witnessing. It is a higher consciousness that is permeating from the grounds in North Dakota right now, around the world, and waking people up to realize that now is our time. And if the Trump presidency has taught us anything, it's that all of us are equal and all of us have to be in this fight together. So thank you for showing up. Please take this momentum and do something. Thank you. Aloha.
You heard from the chairman of Our Revolution, Larry Cohen. Yesterday, he, on behalf of our board, sent out a note to Bernie Sanders asking him to meet us at the White House tonight. I'm here to tell you that Bernie Sanders will meet us at the White House tonight. We will march there together. We will march there together as we march here. My name is Ben Jealous. I'm the former president of the NAACP. I come from a long line of civil rights activists and freedom fighters in this country. My grandma turned 100 2 days ago. She's the granddaughter of slaves. She always told me throughout my childhood, never forget, there are two types of power in this country. There is organized money, and there is organized people. And yes, Trump is president, but we are still a democracy. And if we are organized, then organized people can trump organized money every day. And that means that each of us has to ask our friends to inconvenience their lives a little and stand with Standing Rock. I'm here today because my friend Deborah Parker, you heard from earlier, broke down crying yesterday talking about her fear for her husband who could die at Standing Rock. I spent my life fighting on lots of issues, and sometimes, you know, we get a little weary in well-doing. But I'm testament to the fact that if you just ask your friends to stand with you, they will stand with you. And yes, it's true, the sins of genocide against Native Americans and the sins of slavery against my people are often spoken of as the original sins of our country. But let us also remember the sin of indentured servitude. You see, because just as there are black families in Flint who look at their water and feel solidarity with Standing Rock and the communities there, there are white families in West Virginia whose mountaintops have been blown up and into their rivers, who look at their water and feel solidarity with Standing Rock. Now, if we've learned anything from the events of the last week, it's that we all got to talk to each other. We all have to come together. We all have to recognize that the future of all of our children is at stake, and the only way that we save this country for them, that we save the American dream for them, let alone this planet for them, is we get over everything that divides us, and we adopt the motto of the Three Musketeers, and we say all for one, and one for all. All for one, and one for all. All for one, and one for all. Stand with Standing Rock.
My name is Judith LeBlanc. I'm a member of the Caddo Nation of Oklahoma, and I'm the director of the Native Organizers Alliance. Yes, we have such a great debt to pay to our sister LaDonna and the Standing Rock tribe. In Indian country, they brought us together. The majority of tribes standing together like an indigenous United Nation. And then through the power of prayer and people power, we have brought together an alliance of groups, of movements, of many, many, many people that represent the kind of movement that can save Mother Earth. We owe a great deal to Standing Rock, but really, it's been a Flint moment for quite a while. Flint got everybody thinking about water. And then when we kicked it at Standing Rock, now people are thinking about water is life. So we've got to go to the White House now, because we've got to tell President Obama, step up, step in. Deny the easement. We've got to tell President Obama to send the Justice Department on the ground there to protect the water protectors. We gotta tell the administration that the North Dakota governor get those sheriffs to stand down. Because there's nothing to fear at Osheti Shakon Camp, because it's full of prayer and it's full of people who want to save Mother Earth. So we've got to tell President Obama, and you can do it with a letter, you can call the White House, you can sign a petition online, but we've got to tell President Obama that this is it. This is the way he can seal his place in history by stopping the DAPL pipeline. And let's tell President-elect Trump, you ain't seen nothing yet. You think Standing Rock rocked this world? You try to start the XL pipeline, you'll hear it from us, because water is life.
I want to formally introduce myself. My name is Kwastiwe. They call me Aaron Wise, and I'm from the Hickory Apache Nation in Laguna Pueblo. I speak on behalf of the International Indigenous Youth Council and the Next Seven Generations.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm Madonna.
Hey, Madonna, how are you? Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Ed Jackson with the Army Corps of Engineers, and I just want to, first of all, welcome you to our home here on G Street in Washington. And I want to thank you for being here. I want to thank you for coming and letting your voices be heard. You know, it's a great opportunity for me, on behalf of the Corps, to come out and just introduce myself, be able to listen to the things that you have to say. I'd be welcome to answer any of your questions. Obviously, I know there's a large crowd here, and we probably can't answer everybody's question, but I just thank you for being here on behalf of the Corps. I want to say up front that the Army Corps of Engineers truly respects what you're doing. We take our tribal engagements and our tribal responsibilities very seriously, and we try to continue. We're participating today in some listening sessions. We'll be doing that again in South Dakota on Thursday to try to continue to listen to the tribal voices and understand areas that we can improve in our consultation, which we're doing with the Department of the Interior. So many of you may have been participating in these across the nation. And I thank you for continuing to share your thoughts and your voices with us as we participate in those sessions. So again, thank you again, all of you, for being here. Really appreciate the passion that you have for what you're doing, and I just thank you for the opportunity to introduce myself and to say hello for a minute. So thank you.
Shut it down!
Hey, I don't want I appreciate all of you that are here, but I would really appreciate a moment to speak. As I asked at the beginning of this, we are respectful of our elders, regardless of who they stand for and what they represent. So please, while we're having a conversation, I don't appreciate anybody speaking out of turn. I don't appreciate anyone speaking out of turn. So if it is not your turn to speak and you do not have the microphone, this is not your platform. That is not your platform. So please, thank you for your support. But right now we have questions that we'd have to ask. I don't have an answer for you right now. Thank you. On behalf of the youth, I have a question for you. Do you have children?
I do.
You do, okay. I do too. I live with the Youth Council. I live with 20 youth who every single day wake up and pray that the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is going to not grant the easement to the Dakota Access Company, that they will not allow the Dakota Access to continue to destroy our water. I guess I'm a little upset here because my other question, and I feel like it should be asked, is have you ever been raped?
I have not.
Okay, I have. And when they put that pipeline in our mother every single day they do it, it reminds me of what it was like when somebody forcibly put something inside of me that I did not request to be there. And on behalf of the youth that want to wake up with clean water tomorrow and want to have children consensually,
We are asking you to not grant that easement. We are asking you to stand up on behalf of the people that you have sworn to protect. My grandfather was a member of the United States Army. He was there in World War II. He carried out 6 men at a time from the Nazi encampments because that's how emaciated they were. He fought every single day to remember how to smile because after the things that he saw, he couldn't. We had to remind him every day, it's Soya, it's time to smile. Every single day I look at these kids that have seen more destruction and more disaster in their lifetime than anyone should ever have to. And my little brother and sister every single day come back to me and they say, the mace didn't hurt as bad today. The tear gas didn't hurt as bad today. You know, you took an oath to protect us. Your companions, your colleagues, they took an oath to protect us. And the children are begging you, as an ate, as a father, to protect us. I don't feel that I can trust my government to protect me because it never has. I don't feel safe right now standing here because I'm in front of a governmental building, even though I have written countless letters, made countless videos, and cried on my hands and knees every day to a God that I'm supposed to believe in that this country founded itself upon to protect me when they don't and to protect my kids when they don't. So I guess my only question to you is, what do you intend to do when Dakota Access comes to you with a stack of money saying that they are willing to buy your signature on a document saying that they can drill underneath our sacred waters?
Well, first of all, that won't happen. Second of all, if you saw the Army released a statement yesterday that indicated that we're going to be meeting with the Standing Rock Sioux to talk about that easement in the coming days. And I know that we're already making arrangements to talk with the leadership. And what we're very interested in, over the last few months, the Standing Rock have given us lots of new information. Say again? Have given us lots of new information, and we want to have discussions about that, make sure that we understand that. Because we haven't made a decision yet. We want to make sure we have all the information before we make a decision. But once we have that information, it'll be made on the basis of law and not on the basis of someone sending money under the table, because that won't happen.
Have you been to the Arlington National Cemetery?
Absolutely. I walk the grounds of the Arlington National Cemetery once a week.
Okay, so every single day I walk on the land that Dakota Access churned. The graves that they dug up. Our people are maced. We have dogs attacking us. We have the Morton County Sheriff's Office who have made it their personal mission to hurt our people. And I think that we are respectful of places like the Arlington National Cemetery, and I'm calling upon you and your comrades to ensure that we have the right to protect the burial sites of our ancestors. We don't have spaces created for us where people can go in and take their photo ops. We don't have marked graves. We have mass graves where our bodies were dumped and left. And I'm asking you to protect those sites. I'll let my auntie speak now.
You know, I have a long history with the Army Corps. I'm from the Cannonball River and the mouth of the Missouri River. And I'm old enough to remember what my river looked like before it was flooded. And I remember when my parents moved. I remember when the Army Corps came one day and said my land was no longer my land. And it was the taken land. And I remember my father said, when I die, you bury me next to that Army Corps stake. And we did. And now my son is buried there, on top of that land that looks above the Missouri and the Cannonball River. And I am asking you, don't allow them to build a pipeline next to my son's grave. I'm asking you because too many times you have come and told us the same story. Too many times I've sat with the Army Corps and they told us good things. And they came back and said, I didn't recall that. Too many times we have come to the Army Corps and met good people who turned their back on us. And so I am worried. I am worried because I cannot negotiate. I cannot allow the pipeline to go through. You probably don't understand how much I love my river. You don't understand how much I love my land. And so I'm asking you, I'm begging you, to not allow that permit. I know that Dakota Access filed a lawsuit against the Army Corps today. I know that you guys are being attacked just like we are at this point. I'm asking you to stand and to stand strong as we are.
It's never easy when people have to stand in front of two Native women, so we appreciate that you did. From here,
water is life. Water, yes.
I tried to say thank you to as many people as I seen, but thank you. Thank you. Won't be back. I can't express how much this means. I cannot tell you how shocked I am that people came to stand with us. I cannot tell you how much this means to my people, for the world, for the water, because there's something else going on here greater than ourselves. There's something going on besides Standing Rock. It's about the people
It's about people standing up. It's about people standing together. It's about people. And one of the things that I was told when I was a child, that one day people would look to the indigenous people of the world to help save the world. And I see that. I see that with our relatives, the Maoris and the Aboriginals of Australia, the Samis, the Mongolians, all the Aboriginal people. We do have an answer. We do know how to live with the world yet. And we need everybody to come and stand with us. To honor this earth, to honor the water. Because water is life. Water is life.
Water is life.
I don't know what happened here. I don't know how everybody woke up. And maybe it was a long time in coming. I know none of it had to do with me. It had to do with world conscious. We cannot live the way we've been living. We must stand up and make a better life for our children and our grandchildren. I seen a picture the other day of all these fish that were dead. What are we doing to our world? It breaks my heart when I watch Dakota Access load up our relatives, the buffalo, the other day and took them to slaughter. Those buffalo that I watched all of my life. They are all gone now. And I wonder what gives people the right to end animals' lives. Because every animal dies, takes something of us with them. We must protect the world. We must protect life, and we must protect the water. So I'm asking you all to take time to pray for the water. To stand up for the water wherever you are. To stand. It is time now. We have no more time to waste. We have to save our Mother Earth. We have to stand up. And stand wherever you are. Because you all know. If we do not stand, we die. And I will not allow another child of mine to die. Nor will I allow my grandchildren to die. They have a right to live. My yes. people have a right to live.
Yes.
We have the roots growing right out of our feet. We have been here. We can tell you stories of this land for thousands of years. We know the names of the rivers and the creeks and the roads. We know our homelands. We want you to have the same respect for our homelands, because we love our homelands. We love our water, and we love our rivers, and they must live. So we must stand up. We have no other choice. And so we stand. We stand. Woo!
Wow. Yeah, thank you. My name is Mark Azra. I'm the president of the Fort Belknap Indian Community Council in the state of Montana. And you people are awesome. So I too stand with Standing Rock. Fort Belknap stands with Standing Rock. I believe all of Indian country stands with Standing Rock. But it's really awesome to see all of you non-indigenous people out here supporting Standing Rock. I just come out of a meeting with a senator and was told that this was going on, so immediately joined the march, the movement. I don't want to call it a protest. I don't believe that. It's a movement, and you people are proof that it's going to work. You know, our tribal nations in Montana also sit on the Missouri River. And although this black snake is downriver, it will affect us also. And we're here to support and stand with anybody that's willing to stand with Standing Rock. For us, I don't know that we can pick a political affiliation. We've got to go to anybody. If it's Bernie, come on, Bernie, let's do it. We don't have the opportunity as Indian people to say we're Republican or Democrat. We've got to go to the ones that are going to listen. And in Montana, I can tell you that the tribal vote sways state politics. So they are listening. And we will carry this message back. We reached out to the governor of the state of Montana and asked him to pull back those state troopers that he sent over there. So they're home now. So we're being heard. They're listening, but we can't stop. This is amazing, all of you people. So much appreciated for the folks at Standing Rock and for that council and all of those people up and down that river. You know, the ladies here so eloquently put, it's hard to follow an act like that, but they put, water is life. You carry those signs, water is life. Yes. And we hold that in our hearts. Yeah. That's who we are. We're that water, yeah, that life. And we're going to continue to have clean water. That's what we all want. Every walk of life here, as the first lady put, current president and his family and children drink clean water. That's all we're asking for. Thank you.
Right now, there are two really amazing people behind me that I mentioned before. Jane and Bernie Sanders are here. And as I mentioned, Jane and Bernie Sanders are the only people in the United States government in my lifetime that have ever created a platform for Indigenous communities. I met Jane in Oak Flat, as I mentioned. She actually went and monitored and reviewed the sacred sites that are being desecrated right now. She was there. Bernie has continually called upon our president to stop the Dakota Access Pipeline, and we have so many people here that can bear witness to how fantastic the Sanders are. On my own personal note, Tristan, Jesse, Scott, Eric, I'm standing in front of Bernie Sanders. Not fall when I come down, and then Bernie's gonna walk. I'm like holding onto the kids.
Proud and honored to be with you this evening, and we're proud and honored to be with people in 300 communities all over this country who are demanding that the pipeline not be built. We are honored to be with a worldwide community of people throughout the world who are demanding that the Dakota pipeline not be built. The issues are very clear. For hundreds of years, the Native American people in our country, the first Americans, have been lied to, have been cheated, and their sovereign rights have been denied them. And today we are saying it is time for a new approach to the Native American people, not to run a pipeline through their land. And we are demanding that sovereign rights of the Native American people be honored and respected. And the second issue that we are here for this night is to understand that in the midst of a major water crisis and a growing crisis in our country and around the world, we are not going to allow a pipeline to endanger the clean water that millions of people depend upon. And the third issue is that everybody here understands that not only is climate change real, not only is it caused by human behavior, but it is already causing devastating problems in our country and all over this world. It is totally insane, and future generations will look back on us now and say, what in God's name were you doing? Our job now is to break our dependency on fossil fuel. Our job now is to move aggressively to energy efficiency and sustainable energies like wind and solar and geothermal. The idea that at this moment in history, when the scientific community is crystal clear that we need to transform our energy system, that at this moment we have the fossil fuel industry pushing for more pipelines, for more dependency on fossil fuel, is totally insane. So we say to President Obama, in any and every way you can, stop the pipeline. Tell the Army Corps of Engineers that we know, we don't need any more studies to know, that in the midst of a great crisis, a global crisis with regard to climate change, every environmental study will tell you, do not build this pipeline. And if there are other approaches, such as declaring Standing Rock a federal monument, let's do that. I don't have to tell anybody here that we have a new president coming in who wants this country to become more dependent on fossil fuel, who is endangering the lives of our children and our grandchildren and future generations. What we have got to tell Mr. Trump and everybody else, we are not going silently into the night. The stakes are too high for the future of this planet. We are going to be smart. We're going to educate. We're going to organize. We're going to bring tens of millions of people, moms and dads and their kids, together to tell the fossil fuel industry that their short-term profits are not more important than the future of our planet. Thank you.
That Michelle Obama can hear us. I pray that you listen to us, Michelle. I only want what you want for your children. I only want for my daughters and my granddaughter to live a good life. I want all my grandsons to live a good life. I am not asking for anything but for my children and grandchildren to live, for them to have the right to clean water, and for you to tell your husband because the power has always been in women. To stand with Standing Rock and stop this pipeline. I remember the day when Barack Obama came to my home in Kennebunk, North Dakota. I remember sitting there as I watched those planes come in, and I thought, if my dad was alive, he would have been so proud, a president coming to my home. And I thought, oh, it is so nice to have somebody see us, the indigenous people of this land. And then when the pipeline was proposed, I thought he would stand up with us. He still can stand with us. He said our children were important. I ask you, President Obama, are our children important? We're asking you to put the children first. Put a stop to this pipeline. Stop Dakota Access. Stop energy transfer. Keep it in the soil. We are asking for you to leave this presidency in a good way, with the respect of the indigenous people of this land. We ask
that
you stand up and stand beside us, because we are asking for nothing that is wrong. We are only asking for life. So President Obama, hear me. I am just a grandma. I am nothing more. And I'm asking you for my grandchildren. I'm asking you for my people. And I'm asking you for the water. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline.
Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline. Stop the pipeline.